Today is the 28th October 2017 and it is about 6 in the morning. Tristan's been awake since 2:30. I get married today. And here's Tristan. What's the day?
Hayley's wedding!
Yay!
This is Matthew Satchel.
I'm not Matthew, Baskin, I'm Juan.
Bask in its glory.
It?
Have you know I'm a massive stallion?
Yeah, sure. So yeah, how do you feel?
I'm hyped. I'm good, good.
Get hype?
Yes, I get it.
Hype!
Yeah, I get it.
Hi!
Hello!
How are you feeling?
I'm good. Yo! How are you?
I'm confused as to why you're speaking like that.
I don't know either.
Okay,
bye! Matthew!
Yep.
On the way here, me and Jed had a fantastic discussion to which we busted out my usual I am a cool and malevolent God thing. Okay.
That's a nice smile.
Matt.
Oh, that's nice.
You're getting married. Congratulations.
Ah, glorious.
Tristan, this way. Thanks for it.
No,
don't Jesus, cheese.
Cheese.
You having a drink, Tristan?
Hi, Matt. Well, I'm a little surprised that we're finally here. I guess, you know, it's been a long time coming. Just wanted to say, well, congratulations. It's a big honor to be here.
I get married.
He's getting married.
One day, I shall come back. Yes, I shall come back.
Until then, there must be no terrible partner impressions, thank you.
Oh.
Matthew is in the shot. Hayley will presumably be quite near him. I'm going to adjust the angle slightly. I'm going to adjust my angle slightly so that we catch more of this side of it and thus slightly more of Hayley. Yes, that will be acceptable. That will be most acceptable. I'm going to unbutton myself. just my jacket. One final moment of, you know, nervousness from the groom there. It's all right, mate. You're going to be fine. You know you're surviving.
Well, I can if you want.
All right, all right. Everybody's cool.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the final party. Welcome everybody here to celebrate Matthew and Hayley's love and their marriage together today in the presence of God, Father, Son and Holy Spirit. We have come together to witness the marriage of Matthew and Hayley. Hayley and Matthew are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. We pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Matthew, will you take Hayley to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? And Hayley, will you take Matthew to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? And will you, the families and friends of Matthew and Hayley, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
Fantastic, they're going to hold you to that. Would everybody please take a seat?
Let's get excited.
Love is patient, love is kind, love does not envy, love does not boast, love is not proud, love is not rude, love is not self-seeking, love is not easily angry. Love seeks out what is record of wrongs and does not demand any more but rejoices in truth. Love always protects, love always trusts, love always hopes, and it always perseveres. This is the word of the Lord.
The weather's pretty good today, isn't it? It's looking great, church looking beautiful, bridesmaids looking beautiful, Hayley, you're looking beautiful, Matthew, you scrub up all right, don't you? You're looking good. Just think when Jed broke his hand and you two met at a hospital and chatted about books and your first date in the park and sitting on the bench on the corner here and Hayley's phone smashed, who would have thought that we would end up here with Tristan playing triple jump across your white carpet at a beautiful wedding. Who would have thought we'd end up getting married at one of those first meetings? So Matthew and Hayley, my prayer for you is for you to have a fantastic day today with your family and friends. My prayer is you'll have a lifelong, happy marriage together, enjoying God's wonderful gift. And I pray that when this day is over and reality kicks in, that you'll want to have even more of the wonderful relationship that your marriage is pointing to, the one with the Lord Jesus. Matthew and Hayley, I now invite you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God and his people. I, Matthew, take you, Hayley. To be my wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. According to God's holy law. In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
I, Hayley, take you, Matthew. To be my husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. According to God's holy law. In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
Prince. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Matthew and Hayley a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So Hayley, I give you this ring.
As
a sign of our marriage.
With my body I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Matthew, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body I honour you. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. Within the love of God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. May God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit bless, preserve, and keep you. May the Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. So in the presence of God and before this congregation, Matthew and Hayley have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They've declared their marriage by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Make it right. Snogging to prayer, so please take a seat, and Matthew and Hayley are going to join me this way. Lord of life and love,
hear my prayer.
Faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of love, we thank and praise you for bringing Matthew and Hayley to this day, and we pray for them. Lord of life and love,
hear my prayer.
May their marriage be life-giving and lifelong, enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace. May they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. Lord of life and love,
hear my prayer.
May the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around them. May their love overflow to neighbours in need and embrace those in distress. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May they discern in your word order and purpose for their lives. And may the power of your Holy Spirit lead them in truth and defend them in adversity. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May they nurture their family with devotion. May they see Tristan and any other children grow in body, mind and spirit. May they come at last to the end of their lives with hearts content and in joyful anticipation of the new creation. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
We end with the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Amen. We're going to take a few moments to sign the register.
Thank you all for coming here today to celebrate Hayley and Matthew's wedding and making it such a memorable occasion. Hayley looks so superb today. And Matthew, it's great to have his son-in-law. And they're going to, such a happy couple, aren't they? So ladies and gentlemen, let's be outstanding and let's see, celebrate for Hayley and Matthew, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks, Dad, for that lovely speech. And I'll keep this short, as I'm keen to see my dad on the dance floor. It's been an emotional day, even the cake is in tears. Dad, you've had to travel from Scotland to walk your not-so-little girl down the aisle. Thank you for giving away to my now husband. You've taught me a lot of life lessons, and I appreciate that. I love you so much, you're my hero, and always will be. Granddad would have loved to sung at my wedding if he was here today. Now to talk about my lovely Matthew. We met, from what I remember, in a hostel, a hospital. hospital. I was on the path of moving out of Hull to where my family live, but there was Matthew sitting in the waiting area. I couldn't stop looking at him, and admit, I couldn't stop looking at his lips. So we started off a conversation about books, and from there on, you couldn't stop us chatting to each other. Matthew had been there for me every step of the way and makes a great stepdad to Tristan. We truly are family now. I couldn't ask for anything better. There's a saying, if he makes you feel like a princess, it's evidence he was born and raised in the arms of queens. It is true that men are like stars, with so many to pick from, but only one who can make your dreams come true. Then Matthew is my one true star, and I can't wait for my rest of our dreams to come true. I love you with all my heart, and I know for certain that will never change. I must be the luckiest person on earth, and I know we are going to have an amazing life together. Matthew, you are my everything. I'd like to pose a toast to us. The best is yet to come. To my gorgeous, caring husband, to Matthew. Yay!
First of all, I'd like to thank everyone for coming today.
Hey!
Now, I know what you're all thinking. Come on, Matthew, how much are you paying now? I can assure you I'm just as shocked as you are. I must admit, I've pretty much given up on finding someone when I met Hayley. I guess that was fate's timing. Yeah. As Hayley said, we first really met in a hospital. We were fine, my buddy Jed broke his hand. And we got to chatting while he was in the hospital with his now wife, Susan. What struck me most about that day was the fact that talking to Hayley was ridiculously easy. But for those of you who know me, it takes quite a while for me to get used to anybody. With Hayley, it was different. With Hayley, the first time, I was very comfortable. She got the full-on sort of many, many puns, which I do not regret. We just talked, and while we were on that note, I'd like to thank Jed for being injured. It came in handy. My only pun, I swear. That's my wedding gift to you all. I'll only do that pun, maybe. And since then, Hayley and I haven't stopped chatting, discovering more and more about each other. For example, she really likes Harry Potter, and I have taste. I'm joking. Our love of books is something we share, which means we've now got a very big bookshelf. When it comes to me writing my own stories, she always listens to even the most out there ideas, which 90% of the time I'm with her and I'm coming up with them, so that comes in handy. I look around and I see the people who we wanted here to be. We wanted to be here today. We wanted to be here in a pivotal chapter of our lives. I honestly can't thank you lot enough. It's a funny story with the church we chose. Hayley and I arranged a meet-up on a Sunday, because I have terrible days. And on that fateful Sunday, we had a picnic in East Park. And it went brilliantly. We went out to East Park and we went onto that bench where we took photos today. And while we were talking, Hayley broke her phone. So it's memorable on many reasons. It was good because I forgot the world. I forgot the stresses. I forgot everything. Just an 1 hour test. And we were just there in that moment. Since then, we've had a lot more days out. Movie trips, conventions, midnight releases for books. My favourite though, my favourite's always the quiet nights in. We can talk for hours on end about seemingly nothing, having a lot of inside jokes, making a lot of rants about movies. I like those because, much like that first day, it corners us off from the world. We're basically just us. Much like you are my world, Hayley. A lot of you knew me before I met Hayley, the days when I felt like I was mostly on autopilot, lost in the world with no clear vision. And then I met Hayley, my beacon. She turned the dark nights into graceful ballets between stars and the night sky. Before Hayley, I didn't have a high opinion of myself. My friends were attested to this. I was my own worst enemy, to the point where we made that a theme in a lot of fan films. Now I have an ally. I don't feel the need to hate myself when there's someone who loves a honey writer like I am. I finally understand what my family have been trying to say to me for years. You're you. Hayley and I can spend an entire day just relaxing, and it will be the greatest day. Except for today. Today's better. Today, we write a whole new story. Today, I gain a wife and a son. A queen and a prince. Our kingdom is small, but no less a treasure. And every day is a new gem. Like a race of toast? Well, a glass. To my absolutely amazing wife, and all of you who come over here today. Thank you.
I'd just like to start by thanking Matt for the opportunity to be here. I'm Isaac. Most of you will have probably already met me in some way, but I'd like to say hello to anyone who hasn't yet. It is an honour to be here today, and it means a lot that Matt chose me to be the best man for him. I'd like to think when I first actually met Matt that we hit it off rather well. I don't remember us ever trying to avoid one another in our little group of friends, all of us travelling to Leeds for our rather informal meetings with like-minded people. It wasn't much of an organised thing that we used to go to, just an opportunity for friends to get together in Leeds and spend time together, chatting, gaming, just little things here and there. There were some interesting outfits though. There were usually things like anime girls. Thankfully it was only ever the girls who dressed like that, as far as I noticed. Some obscure TV characters that I certainly couldn't recognise, but always at least a quarter of the group would go as the Doctor from Doctor Who, which inevitably ended up with most of them dressed as the same version of him. Matt was always one of them. Since we were both people with the same general interests, we hit it off almost immediately. I also like to think that things went well with Hayley when I was first introduced to her. It wasn't a huge event when I met her. I just ran into the two of them in town one day when they were going out and I was just happening to be there at the same time. It turned into a little chat that thankfully we've been able to keep up since then. Now, anyone who does know me will know that I'm not the most observant person, and I'm not the best at remembering things either. I never really was able to remember that well about how Matt and Hayley first met, no matter how many times they told me. Really, all I ever noticed was that she made him happy, and that's all that ever mattered to me. Now, I've only known Matthew for a few years, about four now. But I was at least there for a few major changes in his life. It's not a major one, but it is a change. I was there for him starting university, going through university, finishing university, and you'll probably notice a theme here. I was also there for him moving out, him looking for work, a process still ongoing, and also writing his book. And of course I was there when he met and was with Hayley, watching their relationship develop. In the time I've known him, I never saw him happier than whenever he was with her. To my eyes, at least, she was the best thing to ever happen to him. Things have quite clearly changed since we first met Matt.
You've met Hayley, you've moved out of home, and you've got your own with her now, and you and Hayley are married, and all I want to do is wish you the best. I hope you have a long and happy life together, and I'm pretty sure that everyone else here thinks the same. Am I right, people?
Yeah.
Oh, good. So, with all of that ahead of you two, I'd just like to take the chance to raise a toast to both of you and the life waiting ahead. Matt and Hayley!
By thanking Hayley and Matthew for inviting me to be a part of their special day. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Emma, and I am the maid of honour, as well as Hayley's big sister. For those of you who do know me, you're welcome. Hayley and Matthew, I wanted to tell you both how absolutely spectacular you look today. I don't think I've ever seen a better looking couple, except for maybe myself and my fiancé Glenn over there. I had 4 short years of bliss before I was blessed with a little sister. I remember Hayley following me around, wanting to do what I did. We was very close when we was younger, and Hayley used to get me to talk for her due to her speech difficulty, which also made her shy. Now in true sisterly fashion, we weren't always the best of friends. I remember, as I'm sure my mum and dad does, screaming matches, doors slamming, and even an incident where Hayley bit me. But through thick and thin, I couldn't have picked a better partner in crime to take this journey through life with. And now that we are older, I can finally admit that I'm happy to have grown up with such a great little sister. And I hope that I was a good role model in some ways. I'm so proud of her for pursuing her passions and to have become such a wonderful mother to little Tristan. I'm sure if Nan and Grandad could see you right now, they would be so proud of the woman you have become. Whew. I did want to say that I truly appreciate how happy you make my sister. I see Hayley's life like a puzzle with a piece missing, and the missing piece was you. Matthew, you have made Hayley and Tristan's family complete, and you are a brilliant stepdad to Tristan. Today, both our families grew a little bit bigger, and I am happy to welcome you into ours. If everyone could please raise their glasses, I'd like to propose a toast to the new Mr. and Mrs. Matthew and Hayley. Here's to love and laughter and happily ever after. We wish you the best in the future.
We just got married. We just had speeches. It was awesome.
He just gave a speech about how awesome you are.
I think he was there for that.
Yeah, but he might forget. He might get incredibly drunk.
I have a printed transcript.
That's always good. But you to be.
Good point. We might lose this.
I think somebody else recorded the speeches anyway.
Congratulations! It's weird seeing me on camera, but congratulations!
No, hey, you know what? This should be a total Evangelion moment. Congratulations!
Congratulations! Congratulations! Congratulations! Congratulations!
I don't suppose you've got any message for Hayley and Matthew, have you, boy? He just wants the camera.
Hey, Matthew! Matthew!
Yeah.
Hey, Matthew!
What?
Hey Matthew!
What?
Hey Matthew!
What?
Hey Matthew!
Yes, yes.
You married?
I know! I
got how do you feel?
I'm good.
How does that... Let's have a look at this for posterity's sake.
One ring to rule them all. Oh shit, that's a long one.
Okay, but you're not invisible. What the fuck, man?
Must be defective.
It's one of the elven rings, Jed.
They are meant to make mortals invisible.
Did they?
A good point.
Also, it's a son and Hayley! Congratulations!
Thank you.
How do you feel?
Emotional.
I can tell. The whole crying thing probably brings into that effect. Don't worry about it. It was a beautiful ceremony. You did awesome. May I suggest you feel free to cry now? Don't worry. We filmed you with the perfect makeup. We can start recording. You can cry all you want.
You did great, mate.